Utamaru Mono might not seem like a noteworthy title at a distance for those who have not experienced it before, and this is especially true since the original game was released back in 2002 but never made its way outside of Japan. There have been some subsequent sequels in the series, but up until now for us Westerners, the only real way to fully appreciate the story that predated both Mask of Deception and Mask of Truth was to watch an anime. Considering that the Utamaru Mono series is in its heart a visual novel, playing the title in its original Japanese audio and subtitles would almost guarantee that we would miss out on most of the story, so we will more than likely be back to square one in our understanding of the series. That is, until Utamaru Mono Prelude to the Fallen was released in the West. Keep in mind that although the word prelude is included in the title, this in no way is meant to lessen the value of this entry. Not only is the game in theory a prequel to Mask of Deception and Mask of Truth, but in fact the original video game that started the entire series many years ago. The game follows the story of Hakuolo, a man who suddenly appears all battered and bruised in a quiet and poor village, and who has lost all knowledge of who he really is, with the only trace of his past being the devilish looking mask he's wearing, which coincidentally he's unable to take off. Nevertheless, the villagers tend to his wounds, is welcomed to the community, and after doing some work to help out around the village, is accepted as part of it. He then defends the village from neighboring factions, rallying the people around him to overcome the struggle. At this point, the story seems like a traditional Japanese story about feudal families and conquering of territories, but by the end it grew to something much bigger than I had anticipated. While Utamaru Mono Prelude to the Fallen is a turn-based tactical strategy game, keep in mind that it is first and foremost a visual novel. It took me close to 40 hours to complete the game, and close to 30 of them were spent looking at the visualization and reading the subtitles. The only audio available is in Japanese, and although my Japanese is non-existent, the audio itself was very clear and very well acted, properly conveying the emotion of the characters while I read the subtext to keep up with what was going on. Graphically, the game is a 2018 remake of the title from 2002, and although much improvement has been done compared to the original game, Prelude to the Fallen is not as stellar looking when compared to other PS4 titles. If anything, the game is similar graphically to something like Final Fantasy Crystal Chronicles, but with an HD treatment. This is in no way a knock on the game, as the gameplay is mainly done to break this story into different segments, with a 20-minute battle here, then giving way to another hour or two of storyline. The characters each are unique and full of charm, with each one possessing different characteristics, fighting techniques, as well as arts that they can deploy. Your 40-plus hour journey takes you to different parts of the world, where you meet a plethora of different faces and engage in various skirmishes, from defeating bosses to escaping monsters and ultimately saving those you love. Outside of the main campaign of the game, you can engage in training, which are military exercises which allow you to get a better sense of the battle system, as well as free battles, which are the same battles that you have participated in during the storyline, slowly becoming available as you beat them. Engaging in training and free battles will net you items, equipment, and additional battle points to the ones you receive during the game, letting you improve your attack, defense, and magic defense, although this latter one is not necessarily useful until closer to the end of the game. I personally did not do any of the training or free battles until I had finished the main campaign, and to be honest, I didn't really need to. As long as you take care of every enemy during a battle, as well as destroying some of the obstacles, you will find yourself overpowering most of the enemies during the natural progression of the story. Keep in mind that for those of you looking to unlock the Platinum Trophy, completing all training and free battles is necessary. Not only that, but you need to replay the training and free battles in order to complete your item collection, which opens up a new campaign called Where the Wild Things March. Overall, I was very pleased with this story, enough to start making plans to continue the journey with Utaworu Umono Mask of Deception and Mask of Truth to complete the trilogy. Utaworu Umono Prelude to the Falling is my first experience with the genre, and although I do not necessarily have anything else to directly compare it to, I found myself playing longer than I should have each day, wanting to see what would happen next. The game is full of funny moments and takes plenty of sad turns, keeping you at the edge of your seat with an extensive and diverse cast of characters that you get to care for. Like a good bedtime story that your mother used to read to you, Utaworu Umono Prelude to the Falling takes your hand and carries you through a memorable story that will leave you wanting more, as long as you know from the very beginning that this is first and foremost a visual novel and that you will spend most of the game reading text. Utaworu Umono Prelude to the Falling is out now for the PlayStation 4 and PlayStation Vita and does support cross-save between the two titles.